बराबर। हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी असाइनमेंट नंबर 3 ऑफ कंप्यूटर ग्राफिक्स लैब, दैट इज कोहेन सुदरलैंड लाइन क्लिपिंग एल्गोरिदम। इन दिस प्रोग्रामिंग एल्गोरिदम वी आर गोइंग टू एक्चुअली सी हाउ अ लाइन इज बीन क्लिप्ड बाय यूजिंग द टेक्निक्स दैट वी हैव स्टडीड इन द लेक्चर। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। दिस इज द मेन फंक्शन। वी विल स्टार्ट विद द मेन फंक्शन सो दैट द बेसिक points will be cleared, how actually which variables, which points we are going to implement actually. So in this main function, there is nothing but GD and GM that is used to detect the graphics driver and the graphics mode. After that, you have to initialize the graphics, what we say path, so that it is actually retrieving where your program is being stored. That is the Turbo C path. After that, we have created a class named PT. I'll just show you. We have created a class named PT at the beginning of the code. Here is the class PT. In that, we have declared two variables of type integer, that is x and y, and we have made them public because you have to make available these two variables throughout the program. That means the scope of these two variables is throughout the program. Again, we'll move back to the main part. In this, we have declared two variables, that is win low and win high. See over here, PT is a class name, and here we have declared two variables, win low and win high, that will give you the lower coordinate and the higher coordinate of the window. Okay, then PT, again declaring the same class, we have P1 and P2 that are nothing but the two end points of the line that is going to be clipped, and MP1 and MP2 are again two new variables that are going to store the modified point 1 and modified point 2, that is the new end points of the line. Okay, then there is a cout statement return that is going to actually enter the window coordinates, then accept the window coordinates by using cin, that is win low dot x and win low dot y. Again, after accepting for low, you have to also accept the window coordinates for the high point, that is win high dot x and win high dot y. After that, there is a statement for c out where you have to enter the points of a line, that is two end points of a line, x1 and y1. Similarly, after you are printing it, accept by using cin statement, that is p1.x, p1.y. Similarly, you have to accept the end points, that is x2 and y2 for the same line, by again using p2.x and p2.y statement. Then after that, accepting the original endpoints, you have to also accept the modified points of the new line. Or the same line, we get new endpoints. So that are nothing but called by mp1.x equals to p.x, mp1.y equals to p1.y. Similarly, for mp2.x equals to p2.x and mp2.y is equals to p2.y. In this portion, we have done only initialization of the new endpoints that we are getting after clipping the line. This case, this MP1 and MP2 will be used only when the line is getting clipped, that is partially in and partially out. In that case, you are getting, okay. Then clear device, and we are declaring a function called as the draw window. In this draw window, we'll see the detail function, what it is doing. But only in the main, you have to just mention the function by passing two variables, that is win low and win high. Then we are going to use a line function in order to draw a line by using by passing the variables to the line function. Similarly, add a delay so that you can see how the line is getting drawn. Then we are using isDraw variable of the type integer, and we are initializing it to zero. Why? Because See, is draw is equals to clip line. In our program, we have also used a clip line function. This function is used so in order to actually clip a line, and whose result will be stored in is draw variable. Okay. So in this clip line, we are passing certain variables. Which are those variables? Low coordinates of the window, higher coordinates of the window. P1 and P2 are the endpoints of the line that is going to be clipped, and address of MP1 and address of MP2 are nothing but the new endpoints that we have got after clipping. And this address we have used because we have actually created a pointer that I'll show you how we have created. So just for your reference, I am reading out these points. Then clear device. After clear device, apply the condition in the if statement that is drawing is nothing but a variable of type integer if it is exactly equal to zero. Means if its value is zero, then what you have to do? Draw window will be called by using win low and win high variables, or draw window function will be called by using win low and win high variables. Along with that, the line statement or the line function will also get called. Then the delay is added over here, and we have returned zero because just to return the main. Then after this body of the main function, we will come to the upper part of the program where you will see actually how the program is getting run. This is a class. As I had told you, after creating a class, there is another function called as void draw window, which we have already seen in the main function what functionality it is going to play. But in this, it over here, it is given more in detail. That is PT low and PT high. They are nothing but the variables low and high by using the class name, that is PT. Here you are going to call 4 times line function in order to draw the line with respect to, in the comment we have written bottom edge, right edge, top edge and left edge. Okay, but how it is written? The first line function we'll see low dot high, low dot y, high dot x and low dot y. These are nothing but by using purely low dot x means what? You're using a variable, or in short, we can say it is nothing but the object name dot variable, so that it will draw a line with respect to that particular area, that is bottom, right, top or left. Okay. Then after seeing the draw window function, we will move to clip line. See, just imagine the theory that we had taken or we have seen while actually solving the example, just that we are doing. After you draw the window, what you need to do? You need to draw a line, right? That means you need to accept the points. After accepting the points, now there is a time that you have to clip that particular line. So how that line clipping is done? With the help of clip line function. Okay. In this clip line function, we have passed certain variables. The variables are PT is a class with W low, that is lower window coordinate, PT with W high, that is higher window coordinate, then PT1, PT2, okay, that is the original endpoints of the line. Then see over here, we have implemented a star operator. This is nothing but a pointer we have used, that is PT class name star, that is asterisk sign, and MP1 comma PT star space MP2. Over here, why we have taken this pointer concept is because a function cannot return two values. Okay, if we had to return two values, then it was impossible in this process. So this drawback can be overcome by taking or with the help of a pointer. So this pointer will just accept the modified endpoints, and it will point towards those endpoints or towards those coordinates, so that it will be easy for us to draw the new clipped line. Okay. Then After declaring these variables, I have taken AC as a variable that is nothing but to accept the code, and done. Done is nothing but a sort of a variable where how your region code is calculated or how your cases are being carried out. If the region code or the cases are zero or the initial value is zero, then and then only it will enter the loop. Or if it is not zero, it will exit the loop. And loop over here, we have used the while loop. Okay. And unsigned character C1 and C2. In this, you can also make use of integer, but unsigned character is used so that you can reduce the complexity of the code. So we have used unsigned character. Then after that, we have used float m in order to calculate the slope of the line so that it is more helpful in finding the intersection point. Then while loop. In this while loop, we have started with not done. If it is not done, means what? Not zero, it will exit the loop. And if it is zero, then enter the loop, starting with the C1 and C2. This is nothing but the region code of the point one, C1, and C2 is nothing but the region code of point two. So you have to encode these region codes, right? So we have taken P1, that is the endpoint. Then after that, we have taken W low, that is lower window coordinate, and W high, that is higher window coordinate. After same process, instead of just writing P1, you have to write P2 for the code, that is for C2. Then after writing these points, come forward to the loop, that is if. Okay, in this if, what we have done, encode. Why we are encoding these points? Because what we are doing for encoding, we have to actually the ABRL flow, that is above, below, R is right and L is left. So in order to encode these points, that means in which place you have 0, 0, 0, both the endpoints, that means what? The line is inside. If we have written 1 in both the places for code 1 and code 2, this means what? The line is completely outside. And if the ANDing operation is performed for both the codes and the result is 0, this means what? The line is partially in and partially out. So for this process, we are going to require the encoding process. Then how this encoding will be done? If not. Now what does this not means? C1 or C2. Now, as we had studied in the lecture, if the line lies completely inside the window, then no need to perform AND, logical AND operation. We can directly perform OR operation whose result will be what? The line is inside. So we are over here using OR operation. After that, if it is done equal to 1, then it will also accept, that is AC was initialized to 0. If it is done, it will be AC equals to 1. Okay. If the if condition fails, it will come to the else part. In this else part, what we are doing? These are nothing but the three cases we have studied. Okay. The three cases were what? Line is completely inside, line is completely outside, and line is partially in and partially out. So this particular part is just discussing about the cases that we have studied. Then in this if statement, what we have to do? C1 and C2, that is logically you are checking by using AND operation. Okay. If it is done, then you have to return, or the done value will be changed from 0 to 1. Or if it fails, if this is false, then it will come to the else part. Okay. In this else part, what you have to do, actually this portion is related to partially in and partially out line. So over here, first you have to actually calculate the slope, that is m equals to float p2 dot y minus p1 dot y divided by p2 dot x minus p1 dot x. Okay, after calculating this point, we will come to the if section. In this if section, now you all can see there is a new content. What is that new content? I'll tell you. C1 is exactly equal to 0x1. This 0x1 is nothing but the hex value. Okay, so hex value means nothing, but it will, as we had seen in the theory, we had named A, B, R, L as 1, 2, 3, and 4, right? Means your 1 was left, 2 was right, B was, that is bottom was 3 and above was 4. So over here we have taken as 0x1, 0x2 and 0x4. Why we have not taken 3? Because we want that particular value, that is 0001, then 0010 for above, then 0100 for right, and 1000 for below. So these region codes we are going to get by using these particular hex values, and these particular hex values denote that particular region code. So we are using 01 0x2 and 0x4 and 0x8, and they particularly represent their binary values. So we are using these hex values. Okay, then come to the first if statement, that is C1 is exactly equal to 0x1. This 0x1 will perform operations, that is P1 dot Y plus or equals to W low dot X minus P1 dot X into M. This is nothing but pure calculations in order to find out the intersection point, and then P1 dot X equals to W low dot X. Similarly, come again, C1 is exactly equal to 2. Now you have to check for first part, you checked for left side. Second part, that is 0 in X2, will be for right side. Again, similarly, come for third part, that is after left, right, you have to check for bottom. 0x4 will check the bottom region, and then 0x8 will check the top region. Okay, so after that, after performing these calculations along with finding the intersection point, we will move to the next part, that is we have calculated this for C1. Similarly, you have to calculate the all points for C2 as well. C2 as well means the second code that you are going to calculate for the second endpoint. Same calculations will be done, but instead of C1, you have to just place C2, and wherever there is P1, you have to place P2. Okay. So this is the repetitive code for C1 and C2. After performing these points, you have to come to the lower section. The lower section is nothing but the part where you had declared the pointer. Now it is the time to actually give the values to that particular variable. So we have just simply used an arrow operator, and this arrow operator is nothing but we can denote it by using minus sign and greater than sign. So this is nothing but modified point 1 arrow operator x is equals to p1 dot x. Okay, and modified point 1 arrow operator y is equals to p1 dot y. Similarly, arrow operator for mp2 x equals to p2 dot x, and mp2 arrow operator y is equals to p2 dot y. So these four steps are nothing but they will give you your new endpoints for a line that is being clipped, and after that you have to return AC. AC is nothing but the accepted code. Then after that, when you have displayed the line, after the line is getting displayed, you have to return, or you have to show the actual output that is going to be the clipped line. Now I will run the code and show you. Now let me just compile. After compiling, I will show you certain important coordinates. We will enter, say, let's say 100, 100, 300, 300. Okay. Now you have to enter both the points of the line, that is x1, y1 and x2, y2. So we will take, let's suppose 120, 120. And now enter for x2, that is 220 and 250. Okay. Now see, this is our window, and our whatever the points we had given, what's completely inside. So there is no need of clipping, and the result was already a proper point. Now I will show you one more case where you can see a new example. That is, again enter the points for the window. These are nothing but the points for displaying the window. Now enter x1. We'll say now suppose 270, 50. Enter for x2, 350. And next is 120. So just see now, this line is outside before clipping. And it is no need of clipping because the line is already outside. So no, what we can do over here, the line will not be, it is not inside. So no need, the line will be as it is, okay? So there is one thing that I want to tell in this particular point. My task is for you all that you should completely, after clipping portion, this line should get discarded. So this is your task to perform, okay? So there is one thing that I want you all to do. This line, you should perform certain a small change is there in a code. You yourself can do a change. If not, you revert back to me if it is discarded, and then you have to just show me the output that the line is getting clipped outside. I will show you, and let me know if any difficulty you all are having, and please feel free to tell us. Okay, thank you. That's it for today.